The next speaker will be Tolga. He is an anesthesiologist who is working on ultrasound guided interventions and musculoskeletal sonography. He graduated from the Ulida University Faculty of Medicine in 2000 and was awarded the medical doctorate. He became a specialist in anesthesia and intensive care in 2006. Ergönenç joined Sakarya University Education and Research Hospital in 2006 and founded in the same hospital the intensive care unit in 2007 and at the Kiazi Pain Center in 2014. He is currently head of the Kiazi Pain Center and traditional and complementary medicine unit. He has adopted the multi-model approach to pain management, which include pharmacology, pharmatherapy, therapeutic, and diagnostic interventions, and requires close cooperation with psychiatrists, orthopedic surgeons, so a multidisciplinary approach. He has been invited many international pain cadaver workshops on the ultrasound guided interventions and also delivered several lectures on international meeting. And this is one international meeting, so we are very happy to listen to your lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Unstable consists of three oxygen molecules. It's important that we can unstable. It's really important. And it's very high oxidative activity. We need to know ozone gas increase the tissue. When ozone increase the tissue oxygenization and create an analgesic and anti-inflammatory effect by stimulating anginoreceptive system. It's the main principle of the ozone. And all these effect, analgesic effect, anti-inflammatory effect, and the regenerative effect is explained the therapeutic way of using ozone in pain medicine. Over the past years, ozone has gained the popularity in pain medicine, especially treatment to lumbar pain, lumbar disc herniation, and the feedback surgery syndrome, and the musculoskeletal disease, especially shoulder disorders or knee or hip arthritis. This is the cycle of the chronic pain. The trauma results in decreasing oxygen utilization, and the decreasing oxygen utilization leads to decreasing cell membrane potential, and it's increasing free radical damage. Free radical damage is very important, you know. Free radical damage leads to tissue damage, and it's increased inflammation, edema, which leads to further decreased oxygen utilization. When this cycle breaks with ozone therapy, the cell and the tissue can be healing with ozone therapy. As oxygen utilization decreases, in this case of the trauma, the ratio of the NHD to NHDH decreases. This is an important point. NHD to NHDH decreases because of trauma. When the NHD to NHDH ratio decreases into the cell, all the cellular function slows down. All the cellular function, protein synthesis, cellular division, and growth factor function, and the membrane potential maintenance as well, all of them unfortunately slow down. Ozone speedily reacts with lipids and amino acids, and ozone creates a peroxidase. And peroxidase, NHD, H2, NHD, It's another important point. Peroxidase, oxidase, CPP, NHT, H2NHT. So NHT to NHTH ratio increases. Increasing the ratio of the NHT to NHTH results in stimulation of the cellular function. Then oxygen utilization is returned to normal. It's important. The net result is that the tissue receives the energy they need to heal. As the tissue heals, the circulation of the area is restored and the pain decreases. The stimulation of the cellular function is possible with ozone therapy. Ozone therapy stimulates the release of growth factors. It's another important issue. Ozone stimulates the release of growth factors. It's pointed out for the regenerative effect of the ozone and activates the membrane receptors. And ozone therapy restores oxygen utilization as well. The stimulation of the growth factor, especially endothelial factors, are important to tissue regeneration. You remember I said that ozone is anti-inflammatory, regenerative effect, anti-ozone effect. All of these effects depend on the NHT to NHTH ratio. You know, ozone is a gas. Unlike injecting a liquid, the gas expands everywhere and speedily and dissects all area. And distributes to all areas speedily and show to anti-inflammatory effect speedily and everywhere. And ozone diffuses everywhere and large area because of its gas. And sometimes, you know, when you're doing hydrolysis, it's not easy to reach somewhere, but ozone is easily diffused everywhere. It's helped to us decreasing the number of injections needed to treat pain and reduce the chance of the missing affected area. These are ozone generator. That I'm using my clinic, my daily practice. These machines just need oxygen. And you should use ozone compatible equipment, like ozone resistant machine or ozone resistant chamber or ozone resistant bag, tubing and valve. Just this. I mean, this slide. To us, which diseases are responsive to the ozone therapy. In my daily routine, I use ozone therapy for the most painful situations. The Madrid Declaration is our guideline for the ozone therapy. This is the third edition of the Madrid Declaration. You can find everything about ozone therapy, indications, contraindications, volumes, dose, concentrations, for the specific therapies. Please keep in mind. And medical ozone can be applied locally or to systemically in order to achieve to synergistic effect. The various methods can be used together. These are systemic routes of the using medical ozone, and these are the local routes of using medical ozone. In pain medicine, a few ways are preferred for local and the systemic ozone treatment. And you can see in the slide. Local ozone in pain medicine and systemic ozone in pain medicine administrative way. Let's look at some evidence. Let's look at some studies. You can can find all these articles if you can scan the barcode, QR barcode, on the right side of the slide, and you can reach easily all the paper. This one we wrote about ozone therapy for musculoskeletal disorders from USA. And the authors conclude that ozone therapy is an effective treatment option for the musculoskeletal pain disorders, because ozone promotes hyperoxygenation in the tissue that affect on the muscle tendons and the joints as well. And this is an experimental animal study, I like the studies very much, about systemic ozone therapy on tendon healing in rats. They give to ozone rectal insufflation. Rectal insufflation is one of the ways of the systemic use of ozone therapy. And this figure shows us the exploration of the Achilles tendon and the repairing the tendon after injury. And you can see the histopathological compression of the control group and the ozone group. It's very, very good and study about ozone. And the authors are conclude that the ozone therapy may be good therapeutic adjuvant treatment and Achilles tendon after rupture. This is another study about shoulder adhesive capsulitis treatment and intra-articular ozone therapy. Authors do this ozone therapy, ozone hydrodilatation is the most effective shoulder joint adhesive capsulitis. If you do this with ozone, this is not hydrodilatation, this is dry dilatation, such as I used in my daily practice and trapping neuropathy. We are using hydrodilatation, but I use ozone, so we cannot tell this procedure hydro. We call this procedure dry dissection. They do dry dilatation for the adhesive capsulitis. The study's conclusion, the authors found that ozone therapy in adhesive capsulitis was extremely effective. And they conclude the ozone treatment is not has a side effects. It's a good thing about ozone therapy. There is no side effect yet. There's some contraindication, relative contraindications, but there's no side effects. It's very important. And this is another animal study investigated the healing effect of the PRP activated ozone on the synapse tendon on rats. You can see the isolation and string process of the tendon. This is the repairing process of the tendon. And this is the bone interface with hematoxylin erosion strain. And you can see the high vascularity and cellularity in the ozone treated group in this pathological case. And this picture demonstrates the collagen fiber continuity and the arrangement tendon bone interference with the muscle chrome stain. And there is an improved collagen fiber continuity and arrangement in the ozone treated group. These are very important studies. And the conclusion of this study was indicate that the ozone activated by PRP activated by ozone increase the healing of the rotator cuff repair due to ozone stimulating the release of the growth factors. This is the key, ozone stimulating the growth factor to the produce. And another randomized control trial compared the corticosteroid injection with ultrasound guided ozone therapy. And the authors indicate that the one time ozone or corticosteroid injection for treating shoulder impingement improves the pain, yes, we know, yes, disability, scope and the range of motion and ultrasound findings are improved. This positive effect may last minimum 2 months. They suggest that can we can use ozone therapy when the steroid use is contraindicated. I told you ozone is not steroid effect. It's effect like a steroid, effect such a steroid anti-inflammatory side, but it has no side effects such as steroid lactam. If the corticosteroid contraindicated for your patient, you can use ozone safely. This meta-analysis is very important for intra-articular knee joint ozone injection. And this meta-analysis found 3,300
eligible
studies for the meta-analysis, potential eligible studies, and they were select the top 10 quality study after evaluation for the inclusion and exclusion criteria. And these are top 10 qualities study in this meta-analysis. And you can find in conclusion of the meta-analysis, the author suggests using intra-articular knee joint injection of ozone relieve chronic pain due to groin arthrosis. And we know that ozone stimulates the production and release the fibroblast and growth factor. This study about this. And ozone therapy also used for the treatment and trauma syndrome. I use in my daily practice dry dissection for the entrapment neuropathies. And this article about ozotherapy used treating overload syndrome in musician. In conclusion, the author suggested that anti-edema effect, anti-inflammatory and immune moderatory effect make ozotherapy suitable for all acute and chronic degenerative and traumatic disorders in tendon and ligaments. Intradiscal ozone therapy, we call that ozone discectomy, is another way of the shrink to the disc. Because intradiscal ozone, when you inject intradiscal ozone, the oxygen ozone mixture in the mucous composes of the herniated disc. The ozone dehydrates the herniated disc. So, this will shrink and the compression will go. It's very attractive. If your patient disc is not black, the ozone bursts well into the sky, especially the cervical area. You can find all this. Studies when you scan the QR barcode. And this is a photograph from this study. Pre-procedure and the post-procedure. And you can find the conclusion. They conclude that the ozone discolysis or canaliculus has a low risk and the straightforward procedure and alternative surgical treatment in a selected case. And selected case is an important site. In this study, which was conducted two separate groups of 40 patients, it was reported intradiscal ozone application was very effective. And you can find this article easily scanning through our codes. And you can find ultrasound guided facet joint injection in this review as well. Another study compared intradiscal ozone with transferable epithelial injection and ozone administration. And they reported that the combining treatment was superior than the application of intradiscal ozone alone. Another study compared transperineal epidural steroid injection with intradiscal ozone and postural potentiate. And they followed the three groups of the patient for 6 months. And they reported that there is no difference difference between treatment method over the long time? And I would like to show you some injection practice in my daily routine. This is another cross-sectional study from Turkey on cervical intradiscal ozone therapy. You can find the scan QR barcode. Pre-procedure and post-procedure cervical MRI, you can see. Okay, this is a magnesium to perform intra-articular knee joint ozone injection. You can see my needle clearly at the suprapatellar recess, ozone injection. Ozone diffused perfectly. Diffuse everywhere, speedily, and other joint injection, intra-articular hip joint injection. You can see both the needle, an injection after the ozone. Ozone spray everywhere to articulate. And the anti-inflammatory effect and analgesic effect start immediately. And this is another ozone injection, perineural ozone injection. This nervous swell nerves, where it's tiny nerve. And the perineural area is very tiny. You can perform your procedure with ozone injection or perineural ozone injection. You can see my needle, 27 gauge needle, and the cylinder diameter is 1.4 millimeter. Please look at this ozone injection. You can see my needle and my tip of my needle. My tip of needle is perineural area. At the perineural area, yeah. Ozone is spread alongside of the perineural area. Okay, it was my last slide. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you so much. There is time for one question. I see.
Good afternoon, thank you. I have a patient that presented with torticollis, and the reason why is because he's an Olympic shooter, and he's been actually an Olympic athlete, and practicing with a heavy gun and equipment for many hours of the day. So he has now torticollis, and I'm wondering about, I recommended ozone, because I thought that it might help. But I'm wondering from your experience with something like that's as a result of repetitive stress injury. You know, with repetitive stress injury, soft tissue will calcify and even ossify in some cases with repetitive stress. Do you think in a case like that, that ozone may be effective depending on the degree of damage? You understand? Like, it may be, I saw your slide that it does help with ligament and tendon repair, but what are the limitations?
Okay.
Thank you.
The question is dependent on patient pathology and pathology severity. It's dependent on pathology severity of the pathologies. And ozone is an interesting gas, interesting agent. One of doses, many of those of ozone, anti-inflammatory effect produced anti-inflammation. But some of those of ozone has immune stimulator. Some of those are immunodepressant. So you need to choose right dose, right concentration. Intramuscular injection of the ozone is very convenient to muscle strength stimulation. Or intramuscular injection to throat pump injections. Throat pump of some tenderness point when you find with ultrasound or palpation the tenderness point of throat pumps. And you can inject into the throat pumps. It's very effective to anti-inflammatory agent. I didn't have Dr. Carlos experience with ozone therapy. It's dependent on why the torticollis is occurred. It's dependent on what is the physiopathology of this patient. So botulinum toxin may be a good choice for the torticollis, the symptomatic treatment. But I have no experience about ozone therapy with torticollis. But you can use intramuscular ozone therapy for the tenderness of the muscle, the strain of the muscle, or intermuscle of the some wear in the muscle, and the continuity is intact somewhere.
Thank you very much. And we will proceed to the next speaker, and I give the mic to Amar Sati.
Thank you, Rob. So it's a pleasure for me to.